This experiment is a game of two bottles. I have two bottles looking identical, but there is some difference. In one of these two bottles, there is a one hole, and that is this mouth itself. In the other one, we have this mouth and then one more hole here in the body. So that's the only difference between these two bottles. Now the experiment or the game is to fill water in these bottles, invert and see the pattern of falling water. How do they fall? So first I am filling the water in a bottle which doesn't have any extra hole. So now when I invert it, look at the pattern, how it is falling at here. So it's falling with jerks. It is falling with jerks. It's not a smooth flow. Once again, notice how it falls, how the water comes. Does it come continuously or it stops and then comes and then stops and then comes? Is that same bottle without any extra hole? So just look, I'm right. So water, you can see, is coming with jerks and with lot of turbulence, lot of random type of motion. Whereas if I take this second bottle which has a hole, you can see the hole, water is coming out from there, and then I fill water in it and I'll invert in the same fashion and just invert it, and then now look at the pattern. Now how smoothly the water went out, no turbulence, it just comes out so smoothly from its mouth. See it once again. I'm just filling it and now I'm inverting and see the pattern. See, there are no jerks, it comes very smoothly, just water comes, no bubbles, no turbulence, no random motion. So what is the difference between these? Here in this bottle there is only one outlet, so water has to come out from here, and when water comes out, then empty space is created at the top. That empty space has to be filled up by air, that can go only through that mouth. So you have the same mouth, water is coming out and air is also going in from that same mouth, and hence there is a turbulence. Water comes out, then empty space created, pressure goes down, so water stops for a moment and then air gets inside, and then the pressure is increased there, again water comes out. So this way, in steps or in jerks, water comes out, then air goes in, then water comes out, then air goes in, water comes out, air goes in. So it goes in jerks and create turbulent motion. On the other hand, when I invert the second bottle where there is a hole, so when water comes out, air goes through this hole, and that empty space is always continuously filled by the air, and hence the water has can come out through the mouth very very smoothly, because air doesn't rush from there, air goes from the top hole and water comes out from there. Now just look at the two things simultaneously and conclude yourself what is happening and how it is happening.